had expected. FIFA voting unanimously to release an internal report into the turbulent bidding process for the World Cups in 2018 and 2022. FIFA President Sepp Blatter.
We have been in a crisis. With the decision of the Executive Committee today, the crisis has stopped because we have, again, the unity in our government, and this was so important to go.
American lawyer Michael Garcia had conducted the investigation into the ethics around the World Cup voting in December 2010. Russia and Qatar were the respective winners to host the hugely lucrative tournament. But accusations of corruption have continued to plague FIFA since then. The Garcia report was supposed to go some way to ameliorating that. A summary of the report by a German judge, though, caused a storm after Garcia said it didn't reflect what he had said, ultimately resigning ahead of the executive committee meeting in Morocco. Kieran Maguire is a football finance expert.
I suspect that behind the scenes, the FIFA partners, the commercial partners and the TV companies will have been putting huge amounts of pressure on FIFA to ensure that there has been full publication. In terms of governance and transparency, whilst FIFA talk about this in their annual report at length, they don't seem to have applied their own principles.
Outside of the bidding process itself, the World Cup's awarding to Qatar in particular has also been mired in controversy. Accusations about the use of unpaid migrant workers have beset the small but rich Gulf state. That's on top of questions about hosting a traditional summer tournament in a country where seasonal temperatures regularly exceed 40 degrees Celsius. But it's FIFA itself that has come in for much criticism.
It claims to be a charity. When it goes to the individual World Cup countries, it negotiates with the local government to ensure that it doesn't pay any tax and the players don't pay any tax. And there's an awful lot of